newcoins168.com 一个赚钱的网站。大家好，今天是2018年4月27日星期五，我是主持人王蒙宇，欢迎大家收看第143期的 newcoins168 比特币大赢家，一档紧跟加密货币赚钱契机的节目。首先我们先请 newcoins168 的编辑 Cena 为我们分享加密货币市场的新闻和相关期货概念股的表现。
据悉，比特币目前的价格为9019美元。芝加哥期权交易所的比特币期货交易出现意外上涨。Coindesk 报告称，比特币期货目前创下了自 CBOE 12月份首次推出合约以来的最高交易量。CBOE 资深讲师戴文·凯文特表示，随着比特币逐渐走向全球投资的中心地带，越来越多的机构正在进入加密领域。据币安官方消息，币安与百慕大总理大卫·波特签署了谅解备忘录，就合作达成协议。加密货币方面，截至发稿时，24小时涨幅最大的币有 GTO、STEM、BCD、Loom、SCAE 等。24小时跌幅最大的有 Bitcoin Private、SUB、KIN 等。比特币期货方面，截至发稿时，芝加哥期权交易所 CBOE 今年4月交割的比特币期货合约 SBT 下跌 1.21%， 报8980美元，交易量超过3711手。芝加哥期货交易所 CME 今年4月交割的比特币期货合约 BTCF 报9230美元，交易量911手。比特币概念股方面，比特币 ETF GBTC 上涨 0.98%， 报15.5美元。主板比特币概念股 OSTK 下跌 0.27%， 报37.15美元。SNET 上涨 0.62%， 报13.08美元。GROW 上涨 0.34%， 报2.91美元。IOT 上涨 0.27%， 报7.49美元。此外， OTC 市场比特币概念股近日整体下跌。截至发稿时， BITCF 下跌 3.58%， 报0.35美元。MGTI 上涨 1.63%， 报1.87美元。BTC 上涨 0.68%， 报0.15美元。GLNF 上涨 3.86%， 报0.46美元。
好的，谢谢今天的新闻及行情整理。接下来我们请到了中文投资网的分析师 Jason 为大家解析几大加密货币近期走势。Jason 您好。
Hello， 主持人哦，广大的加密货币爱好者大家好啊，又来到了我们加密货币分析的小环节。那么最近两天的话呢，我们看到了加密货币市场整体出现了一个调整性格局啊，除了强势股 EOS， 那么有相应的表现以外，其他的不同的货币呢都出现了一个调整性的格局。那么我们现在看到的是比特币的四小时图。那么四小时图当中的话呢，我们看一直依托在55周期均线上方进行一个上涨格局。当触碰到9700美元之后，那么这个大幅度回调到8700美元，反弹到9400。那么现在的话呢，在9000美元左右徘徊。总体上来说呢，要看最终这个整理方向啊，这个整理的一个结构，最终的一个方向性选择。那么我们看市场的一个自主的选择过程，然后我们再采用啊相应的一个策略啊进行交易。总体来说呢，在这个位置上横盘之后，向上还是有上涨概率的可能啊。那么试探11000美元、10000美元上方啊，这个可能性还是有的。所以呢，我们要看纵深的一个发展过程。那么以太币的话呢，反弹的空间比较这个比特币来说呢相对的猛一点，向上的话呢看到了680美元上方，现在回调到654美元。所以总体来说呢，在这个位置上我们也可以把它看作成是一个整理性结构啊，也可以把它看作成是一个整理性结构。所以呢，总体加密货币市场现在还是整理，整理过后的话呢，等待方向性的一个选择。瑞波币总体来说相对弱一点。我们看这一轮的反弹的话呢，连8.5毛钱上方都没有触碰。所以总体来说呢，瑞波币在9毛钱上方的压力，这一次的反弹恐怕很难过去啊，很难过去。所以呢，瑞波币我们应该保守对待啊。比特币现金，那么前期啊这个拉幅的幅度比较大，在四小时图上的话呢，21周期均线被破掉，现在反抽，现在进行一个横盘整理，预计呢上涨态势已经得到了一个非常明确的停止信号，那最多呢就是一个高位盘整。所以从总体上来说呢，比特币现金我们也要慎重对待。那现在唯一能够有一点点希望的 是以太币还有比特币啊，这两个大币种啊。那么看一看这个整理性格局完结以后的方向性选择啊。那这是咱们今天的小节目啊，那也感谢大家的收看，咱们下次节目再见。
谢谢分析师 Jason 带来的操作技术分享。接下来是我们的全新加入单元中文投资网 NewCoins 168的 ICO 分析师 Preston Home， 从今天开始将为您带来每天两分钟来自币圈内部对于趋势的专业分析。让我们一起来看 Preston 今天谈的 ICO GIFTO。
Hi, everyone. My name is Preston, and for today's ICO update, we are going to talk about GIFTO, ticker price GTO. So GIFTO is a decentralized virtual gifting platform based on the Ethereum blockchain. Most recently, in the past 24 hours, it has experienced an almost 45% increase in price. The market capitalization is sitting at a measly $240 million with plenty of room to grow. Most of the trading volume is on Binance, and coming in second is OKX. These are all good signs of some great movement. On the daily chart, GIFTO is showing that it is well above the 8-day exponential moving average, the 20-day exponential moving average, and then the 50-day exponential moving average. So we are in the clear for the short term and intermediate. The RSI has shown a bullish divergence since April 4th, signaling the uptrend. There's still some space for movement upwards, even though we are at 80 RSI, signaling it could be overbought. If we entered a trade where the EMAs crossed at about two and a half cents and sold right now, we would be up 123%. Also, just a quick update on yesterday's coin that I talked about, Dragon Chain, it has been up 6.64%. That was your daily ICO update. Have a great weekend. I'll see you Monday.
谢谢分析师 Preston。 今天的比特币行业采访继续是在香港进行的达士币 Dash 高层采访。达士币作为目前前五名贵的加密货币，除了交易开发，也有教育的使命在。
So I guess a couple of things is one, a lot of coins also have different uses. So not, for example, Ethereum is a smart contract platform. So that's a different use case, say, compared to Dash, which again is an alternative form of payment. So they're not always, yeah, I mean, they're both cryptocurrencies, but they're not used in the same way. So it's not always an apple to apple comparison. But, you know, I think, again,Dash is focused on really kind of two main attributes. We are near instant transaction speeds, and we do that through the instant send feature. And then in addition, we are also, we transact very cheaply. An instant send, thank you. An instant send transaction right now costs about 4 US cents. So it's super quick, it's super cheap. That's our focus. We do have an optional privacy feature, but one, it is optional, it's not automatic. And then two, it's also, right now it's a little bit less than 1% of our transactions. So, you know, our users are really focusing on that ability to instantly transact and to transact at a very, very low cost, as kind of our key value proposition.Yeah, well, I mean, that's one of the other strengths of Dash is really our kind of strong community focus. Our very strong community, which then focuses on a lot of elements, and education is one of those. So a perfect example is Venezuela is a market that's very important for Dash for a variety of reasons, but which I can go into as well. But we have a very strong community base in Venezuela that is doing a lot on the education piece.And this is that proposal process I mentioned. There's community members that have successfully, or that are putting up proposals to the network to fund a help desk. You know, so that a Venezuelan says, oh, how do I download a wallet? Okay, they can email a help desk, you know, or again, a merchant acquisition campaign. They want to do something where it's, I think it's around roughly 2,000 different merchants and, you know, on the ground, you know, kind of talking with them, discussing with them. So the community provides such a strong, or sorry, such an important role in helping with that education. And then the best part is that Treasury Fund provides also then a mechanism or a means to help them with that education process.
以上就今天的 New Coins 168比特币大赢家数字货币赚钱资讯美股最新动态，敬请关注中文投资网实时更新，感谢您的收看。